Yo guys, welcome to today's video. This is just going to be a chest workout of mine. So if you guys have Pectus, you should be super interested in this. Rocking these shorts, I thought I'd give a shout out to Gym Steez because these are my favorite shorts ever. Alright, so I'm just going to talk over it and explain this workout and why I'm doing each exercise as we play through it. So first up, the first exercise you can see me doing here is bench press. So like I've talked about before, you got to start with your compound movement. So even if you are Pectus, we want to start with compound movement. So particularly when we're training chest, we want to be doing a big press. Normally a flat press, so we can be as strong as possible and focus on progressive overload and getting stronger on those lifts, okay? So you choose a given rep range and you want to get stronger in that week by week and progress, because that linear progression is the biggest key for muscle growth. So we did the flat bench press first, we did 3 or 4 sets of that, and then we moved on to incline dumbbell press after that. Again, another compound movement, and the incline is just going to make it target your upper chest more, so hence why we did incline. And I'd say it's good to do two big compound movements when you're training chest or any muscle group really. And so when you're training chest, generally do like 2 presses, one flat, one incline, one flat, one decline, incline, decline, that kind of thing. Right here you can see me doing the landmine press. I've talked about this before as well. One of my favorite Pectus exercises. And again, as you press the weight up, I just want you to tilt your elbows in, because that's really gonna activate your chest and activate your inner chest and those fibers in and around the indent. Like seriously, look at that right now, all the striations on the screen. It's really building in and around my indent, so that's a great exercise for you guys. Definitely do that. And we actually supersetted it with the dumbbell pullovers. This is like the Pectus extraordinaire superset right here. Like you got the landmine press, boom, building right in around your indent, and then you got the dumbbell pullover. You guys know, if you've been following me for a while, how bloody good the dumbbell pullover is for Pectus. And I've really been focusing on just going pretty light with the dumbbell pullover and just really feeling that stretch, keeping my arms as straight as possible and my elbows locked in as close as possible to really put the stimulus on my chest and take it away from my lats, because the pullover works both chest and lat. And then here is me doing dips. So either do dips as like a heavy compound at the start of your chest workout, or you can do it later and just burn it out. So here we're doing it later in the workout, and I'm doing a chest, doing a chest variation where I'm leaning into it more to really tug at my chest in and around the indent. So dips are awesome. And then last exercise is the cable fly. So I think it's really good to finish with a fly. Sometimes you can actually start your workout with a fly to pre-exhaust your chest. That's getting a little complicated. For some of my clients online, I get them doing that on their second chest workout each week. But flies definitely should be included in your chest workouts. I love cable flies, the pec fly machine, all kind of flies, they're great. You're stretching the chest, really being able to break down muscle fibers in your chest, build them back bigger and stronger, baby. It feels so good. And then I always finish my chest workouts with push-ups, just one set as a burnout set. So all my online clients have that as well. So that's what you saw me doing there. And then after chest, we just moved on to do a little bit of triceps as well. This is like your chest and tricep split. I do recommend if you're a beginner, maybe doing an upper lower or chest, shoulders and triceps. But today we were just doing chest and triceps. So we did the rope pull downs or the V-bar pull downs and then the overhead. So when you're doing triceps, you want to kind of do like a pull downing movement and then an overhead movement to hit different heads of your tricep. So I love the dumbbell overhead that you can see me doing here. And yeah, that's the workout, guys. So I hope you liked that. Did you like me like talking in this as I watched it and explained to you guys? If you did, then let me know in the comments below, because I'll do more of this kind of stuff on my YouTube. And also guys, I really want to do a Q&A, so if you guys want some questions answered, then comment below the questions and I'll answer them in my Q&A video, which I'm going to post soon. And also, I know a lot of you guys have been saying shave your mo. By the way, when you comment that, it really fucking annoys me, because I don't care about your opinion in regards to the way I look. Like, I'm gonna do me, and that's what a lot of you guys need to concern yourself about, is do you. But I actually, for my own self, feel like it's ready to get rid of the mo. Not for you guys, but for me. So I think I'm gonna shave it. So stay tuned for that if you've been waiting for me to shave my mo this whole time, because she's going. Hi mo. But yeah, guys, comment below questions you want answered. I'm really excited for the channel. I edited the start of my transformation video, which I've been getting up to you guys, and oh my God, it's gonna be epic. Cut's coming along well, almost finished the cut, almost finished making this transformation video, and I have a feeling business is gonna be booming after that. Thanks so much for watching. If you like the video, give it a like. Remember to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And guys, seriously, I wanna make an epic Q&A, so hit me up with all kinds of questions, whatever you wanna ask, and I'll be answering it in my future video.